Well, good morning, everybody. As you can see, whole crew's here. All the deer showed up earlier. Coming by to get their breakfast here, blazing in the backyard, carrying on. I'm out here getting the boat ready. About to get rigged up for the day, head out on the water. But I'm kind of rigging rods and stuff. And anyways, we get set up and head out. I just figured I'd kick this one off. A little bit of deer footage. We used to do this a lot here on the channel. All the little deer here in hill country come by every day to say what's up. There's a bunch of them. There's a couple really nice bucks here this morning. See that dude right there? He's cruising through. A couple smaller bucks and then one other one that's huge that already left before I could kick the camera on, but he smelled like a freaking barnyard. Full-blown stink, most horrendous smell. Actually, really quick, oh shoot, look at that one right there. She got injured, hit by a car or something, but she's doing good. She's gonna make it. Anyways, yeah, rigging up the rods. We're gonna go out and see if we can catch ourselves some fish. It's a beautiful day in hill country. Pretty healthy looking dude there. Anyways, show you guys what I got going on out here on the tackle table. Been messing around with these new treble underspin heads. We got the line through jig heads on deck. Gonna be throwing some swim baits and square bills and whatever else I need to throw to try to catch fish, honestly. Oh, can't show any of this stuff. This is all super top secret. Can't see any of that. Need to put the whales in the boat. Got my treble head, line throughs on deck, grabbing some treble hooks. And there's a quick look at the tackle table. Current state of the tackle wall. It's a beautiful morning here in hill country. See everybody's out with their dogs and everyone here living together in harmony. I sure do feel blessed and grateful to be alive here in hill country. We got the garbage truck coming down the block. We got the deer in the background. We got everything, everyone, everybody out here living in harmony in hill country, and I love it. But sun's creeping up high in the sky. We don't have much time to waste. Honestly, I'm just trying to decide if I'm gonna leave Blaze here at the house or take him with me. Because last time he pooped on the boat, you guys know the rules. You poop on the boat and you gotta skip a trip and stay at the house. So I think we're gonna fly solo out there on JB today. We gotta rip off, man. Let's get rigged up and head out on the water as the garbage truck comes up the block in the background. Man, when I was a little kid, I always used to love going out and watching the garbage man come and pick up the trash. And then if you were lucky back in the day, you got to see them do the thing where they smash the trash and use the hydraulics to compact it down so that they could fit even more trash in the truck. Let me know if you guys were born in the late 70s, the 80s, or the 90s, and you remember when you were a kid going out to the curb and watching the trash truck come pick up the trash. When I was a little kid, I loved any type of heavy machinery, big tractors, big trucks. I was all about it. Dinosaurs too. I know some of you guys that watch my channel probably were too. Whenever they would use that truck to smash down that trash, that made my day when I was a little one. Anyways, just thought I'd share that memory with you guys. I know some of you guys probably have that same memory. Drop it down in the comments and let me know so that we can connect. But let's connect through bass fishing and go see if we can catch ourselves some fish today. It's just a beautiful day. We're gonna go throw some baits, have some fun, catch some bass out there on JB. Let's rip off, man. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Shout outs to the trash truck. Shout outs to the garbage men, all the service workers out there, anybody taking care of us, man, doing that real work right there. Mad respect to these gentlemen right here. That's that real work. Mad respect, much love.
I can try to film myself rigging up some of these treble heads. Haven't played around with these much, but we're gonna learn them together. 7.2 medium heavy, I know it's upside down. 7.2 medium heavy mod fast heater series. It's my chatterbait rod. This is what I'm gonna be using to throw the treble head today. See here. Whale 3.5. The deer are gone. I hear Blaze over here kind of squeaking and whining to get out. I'm gonna let my dog out real quick. See if he can make a quick cameo in the video.
Let's cruise back here.
Right here behind this gate. It's a winter. I'll be the man.
Don't run off, dude. Don't chase anything. Don't kill anything. Let's see if we can get him to jump in the boat. Blazer, can you hop up? That wasn't too hard for you.
Hey, good man. Good man. Good man. Good man. Good man. That's my boy.
We gotta get rigged up, dude. We gotta get rigged up. Chill. You're not going. You're not going today. Watch out. There's treble hooks up here, man. Come on. Get your ass back, Elroy. That's my man. And hey, remember rule number one, no pooping in the boat. That's my man. Look at that dog, dude. Look at him. Look at you, dude. You're a bad motor scooter. Come on, you can get down. Come on, jump down. Just jump down right here. Hey, right here. Come on, down. There we go. That's it, man.
Oh, oh, oh.
Back to this. This is what we're doing here, okay? Let's focus. Focus up.
Focus in. I can't see how the camera looks, what the camera angle is like right there, but hopefully my dog doesn't run away and we can get this bait rigged up and actually go fishing today. Where is it? Where'd it go? Where'd he go? There it is. That little guy. And then these guys. Whale 3.5 Ghost Ice Minnow. They got one little black flake in there somehow. See it? You see it? Let's figure this out together. So this, obviously, it's gonna screw into this. Swizzle.
Swizzle.
Okay, on in. What we got so far there, little guy. Take this guy. What's up, buddy? All right, sorry if the camera angle changed. I had to check and make sure I was recording. I couldn't remember if I hit the button. Now I think we just tied the hook on, if I'm not mistaken. There we go. There's our setup. We'll see how she rolls. We'll see how she swims. And we'll go from there. I'm gonna rig up a couple of these and get out on the water. See you guys on the lake.
All right, as you can see, we're down here with JB and it's warming up fast. So we gotta get this boat launched. I've already stripped the hoodie off, but that's a beautiful day here in Hill Country, man. Check out the lake. She's butter, a little bit of ripple on the water. We're gonna throw some finesse swim baits, see if we can get some eaters to come up and smash up shallow. That's what I'm hoping for. Let's get the boat launched. Ooh, JB looking fresh back there, no doubt. Freaking love my boat. I'm gonna be doing a boat update video soon. I'm gonna talk about the future, my fishing situation, my boat situation, future of the boat here on the channel, and what I plan to do bass boat wise going forward. And I would love for you guys to stick around, check out that video as soon as I have time to get that done. I will get that done for you. But right now we're trying to launch the boat. That's priority numero uno at present moment. It's just backing down the boat ramp, you know, which I've done about 16 million times, as I'm sure many of you have, and it becomes quite second nature, especially on your home ramp, you know, the ramp that you're most familiar launching on. It becomes like you can almost just do it in your sleep. I mean, it's you know, like the butter zone, you know, the exact spot on the ramp that you want your trailer to sit when your boat you know, touches the water, you know, just all that good stuff. You know, I'm probably just rambling on and not making any sense, but anyways, we're backing the boat down. We're about to get this thing, about to get this sucker tossed in the water here, boys. That's what's going on. So I get it. When I'm backing my boat and I'm launching my boat, I go to right before I see your start. That's a little far. That's actually a little far, but that'll do. Anyways, I see fish up shallow. Let's go. It's actually a little far. That's a little deep. Turns out that was just about perfect. So that worked out great. Yeah, I like it. I like it when the boat doesn't roll off the trailer, but then once I walk into the boat, it does. Then we just get a nice, smooth, easy launch. I'm gonna beach her right here. To go, man, we'll be good to go. Freaking woo! Goes my crickets. Nice. Oh, shoot. Gotta get all this. There we go. Yup. Yep. Alright. And I usually just park right here, you know. Just park her right on right here. Off-road style on the side of the mountain. Grab again. Time to go. Fishing, girl. Let's go. All right, dudes. That's it. Time to go fish. Let the good times roll. Loner looking sick. No, that's not the loner. That's the rental. Rental. Rental's looking sick back there on the hillside, man. Truck looks good. Let's get the cricket legs up. Look at that bluegill. Right up here on the boat ramp. Super shallow. Bait fish up shallow. It's good. All good things.
get the cricket legs up, get the boat out here into the lake, do some fishing. It's looking good. It's looking right. It's gonna get the grinder. I'm gonna put the trolling motor down right here and just start throwing. I'm feeling it. I feel good. I see fish everywhere. I'm just gonna start fishing. Why not, dude? Just start fishing at the boat ramp. Really, you just get a boat, get this super expensive boat, dude, and then you just launch it right here, and then you just start fishing. That's how crazy we are, dog. We're out of our dang minds to try and catch these little green fish. That's what I'm gonna do right now. Wanted to see if I could cheat the odds and get bit there at the boat ramp without having to go far. Didn't work out for me, so we're gonna make a quick run here. Bass boat out here in front of me. Bass boat just ripped by a minute ago, so we got a little bit of company here in this area of the lake anyway, but that's cool with me. I don't mind sharing the water with the homies. Let's go bebop about a half a mile up the block, and I'm gonna hit a spot. I'm gonna go hit a spot we ain't fished in a while. See if we can find them eating these little swim baits, man. Gotta make a run, gotta throw my jacket on. See you guys at the next spot. All right, we just pulled up to the first official fishing spot on the day. Not at the boat ramp, but at somewhere else. So yeah, if you guys remember last time Blaze was out here with me, left him at the house this time because he pooped on the boat. And he hasn't pooped yet this morning. So I was like, man, you can't go if you don't poop, and no poop, so no boat. Luckily, we were able to hit it with the pressure washer. Good to go, boat is clean, happy to report. Let's get back to fishing. Start out throwing around the edge of this marina, and then we're gonna work our way down the bank. I can feel the tail on this whale thumping when I burn it, and it's just a soft plastic. I love that. I love it when I can feel the thump of a bait and it's not a chatterbait or a squirtbill. You know what I'm saying? Especially if it's a soft plastic, that's just special. Thumping, dude. Or maybe it's just a testament to the freaking sensitivity of the almighty heater series. A lot of people tell me this one's their favorite, the 7.2 medium heavy mod fast. Definitely an extremely versatile rod. Fish number one. Boom. It's a quad. Nice, dude. Freaking roasted it. Now there we go. We get a good look at the benefits of the treble head line through. You see how that bait busted loose and slid up your line? Now all you have to deal with is the treble hook in the fish. And this right here is gonna make, it's gonna make it less likely that your fish is actually able to throw the bait. Once this treble hook is in him and that bait slides up the line, he's in the boat. Boom, just like that. Nice quad, first one on the day. Let's keep rolling. Slide our bait back down. Blow the bee out of your face. You wanna find the part of the hook that's flat. So you see how when I hold the hook like this, the eye of the hook sits flat against the swim bait and there's one hook point going down. That's, you gotta figure out the orientation. You see, if I hook it like this, that's wrong. This is the right way to hook it. Keep that in mind. Just like that right there, to where the hook sits flat against the body. Boom, ready to rip. So I have my boat sitting about 15 or 20 feet off the shoreline, and I was just casting to little individual target rocks along the bank. So I'm gonna reposition back out here, drift it in a little bit. Let's keep freaking rolling, dude. That was fun. Got us one. That's the way to start the day. Little Guadalupester. Shout outs to the Guad Squad. That's us. We are the Guad Squad. You guys let me know if we should make Guad Squad t-shirts. I feel like I've been talking about it for years. It's about that time. Let me know if you'd buy a Guad Squad t-shirt. You guys really seem to love the merch every time I do restock it. It sells out. So you guys let me know if you want the hats and the shirts to come back, and if you'd like to see some new t-shirt designs. I need the feedback though, because that's what boosts my confidence. That's what gets me like hyped up to do it, is when I hear from you guys. That's why I did it in the first place. is because I was getting so many comments from people telling me, you need to make some shirts. You need to make heater shirts. Anyways, let me know. Enough of that. Enough about the merch. Quad squad. I want to catch another fish. That was fun.
There it is.
Take long. Is that the next cast? Let's see. Another quad. Watch this treble head line through. Slid up the line. It's a nice quad. There you go. See that bait slid up the line like that? That's a nice one. Healthy quad. Fish number two. Bait goes up the line. Hook stays in the fish. And that is what's most important, right? Healthy Guadalupe bass, man. State fish of Texas. Beautiful little hand grenade, man. Nice. Let's keep grinding. Later, buddy. See if we can catch us a big one. Nice, dude. Okay. Ghost Ice Minnow. Whale, 3.5. Sixth-inch treble head line through. One of the most innovative and cutting edge, coolest pieces of terminal tackle that I've ever seen. I slept on it at first, admittedly. Some things come out, you know, Sixth Sense is constantly dropping new stuff. I work very closely with them and they send it all to me. And sometimes it takes me a while to get to things. I'm not even gonna lie, there's so much stuff that I need to fish and experiment with. And the treblehead line through sort of fell to the bottom of the pack or the back of the line or whatever you wanna call it there for a while. I gotta give credit where credit is due. I have a friend in the neighborhood who told me, hey man, I've been throwing that treblehead line through, and he says he takes one swim bait and he throws that on the treblehead line through, and the swim bait lasts him all day and he loves them. But anyways, it got me thinking, dude, I need to tie that thing on. If they're eating it and it's doing so well for you, I want to see if it can produce for me. We got two in the boat already. Five fish makes a video. Everybody knows the rules. We broke the rules in the last video. Only caught three fish, but Blaze pooped in the boat, so I made a video out of it anyway. Today, hopefully, we can crack off a five piece and get it done here on the treblehead line through with the Whale 3.50 Ghost Ice Minnow. Catching fish gets me amped up. You guys know I start the day, I'm all mellow, and then I just get a few hook sets, dude, and then I'm just zinging. All I've drank today is water, no caffeine, no electrolytes. I'm trying to get back on my freaking fitness and get my ass back in shape. So I gotta cut the calories, cut the intake, so I'm fasting, and hopefully, oh, you guys can tell how excited I am to just have caught a couple little quads so far. Let's keep it grinding, keep it rolling. We can catch some more. I was rambling. Fishing gets me hyped, dude. It's fun. There he is. Nice. Watched him eat it. That was sick. Watched him eat it. It's another quad and it's the biggest one. They're getting bigger. Watched him eat it right in front of me. I was burning it. That was sick. See how the fish is trying everything he can to throw that bait, but he can't do it because it slides up the line. He's got no weight to work with. It's just that hook point. Hooked right in the roof of the eater. That's three fish in about 5 minutes. Perfect hook set right in the roof of the mouth. Easily removed. Fish is unharmed. Nicest one of the day. Let's keep grinding. That's three quads, man, on the treblehead line through with the Ghost Ice Minnow Whale. About to smash into the dock. JB, hold it down. There we go. All right, so you guys know me. I ride with Sixth Sense, and I throw a lot of Sixth Sense baits, but there are some other baits in the boat. You know, be honest with you guys there. We just collided. We've had a collision. There are some other baits in the boat, you know, and certain swim baits, they don't last too long. They are incredible when it comes to action, but the durability seems to be lacking. That's the case. You know, you sacrifice durability for action. You sacrifice action for durability. You got to find the balance. But there's a very popular swim bait on the market, probably the most popular swim bait on the market when it comes to paddle tails, small profile, single swimmers like this. And they're known for having incredible action, but the durability is not quite there. Well, my buddy that told me that he's been fishing these line throughs says that he can take one of those very, very popular, and I'm sure you guys know which fat little swim bait I'm talking about. He said he can take one of those, and this bait is not cheap. This is an expensive bait. It's a more higher quality bait, more sought after bait. It's a little pricey. He said he can take one and he can throw it on the treble head line through all day. So keep that in mind. Not only will this thing catch fish, help you get more fish to the boat, but it'll help you save money. SixCentsFishing.com, JR10 for 10% off everything on the website. Secure the heaters, save the bread. Check out the treble head line through. Grab yourself a 7.2 medium heavy mod fast heater series rod. JR10 is gonna knock $15 off the price of the rod. It's one of the most affordable rods, my signature series, the rods that I use and trust every single day here on my boat. Get out there and smash you a dragon. Let's get back to fishing. We're literally in the dock cables, dude. Let's get out of here, dude. Come on. Off we go. Loving this thing so far. Three fish in the boat, all quads. That one ate it right here. I just saw the fish come out, saw the mouth open, flash, saw the bait disappear. Freaking rodeo time after that. Swing a hook set and just, and then just lift them to the boat. I mean, dude, what else do you want? What else do you want, Elroy? There's bait balls everywhere. I can see the bait just flying out of the water when I swim this thing through the bait balls. I was burning it when that fish ate it too. I could feel the bait thumping like I was talking about earlier. Got the 4-inch tied on too, or the 4.5 with the 3/8 ounce. So we can try to draw out a bigger bite. Nice. Get out of there. Runner. Another, it's the biggest freaking quad I've ever caught in my life, maybe. Dang, look at that quad. Four quads. That might be my PB. If that's 2 pounds, that's my PB. Dude. All right, dude. Let's get a weight on this fish, dude. I don't think it's going to do it. It's 2 pounds. That's my PB. 1.36, not even a pound and a half. Got a little excited. 1.36 pounds, let's let her go. Ooh, nice fish, thanks girl. Thought it might've been a 2. No worries, fun fish. That was a fighter, healthy too. That's 4. We've only been fishing for 15 minutes maybe. Life is good, it's been a good day so far. Let's keep it rolling. Right over there in the corner pocket. 8-ball in the corner pocket. He had it, dude. He had it. He took my bait. I felt him hit it on the fall. I threw it out there and just let it sink, and he smoked it. Good thing I got the whole box back here brand new. He yeeted it off with my freaking whale ski, dude. So let me tell you guys a little trick that I learned that you want to do on these. Is you think you want to put the pin in right in the dead center. Don't do that. Put it in a little bit below, like on the chin. See down below? Do it like that, trust me. And then once you've got it tied on, you're gonna wanna use the bait to spin, not the treble head. Otherwise, you're gonna get your line all twisted up. You might have to, like I'm about to have to. I'm also getting blown into this freaking dock cable. That's cool. But anyways, go in a little low. You'd think from getting all tangled up like I'm doing, this could be an issue. All right, switch hands makes it easier. Go in a little low. Once you get the bait married up to the head, see how the chin tucks up under the bait like that? There you go. You wanna go in a little low. It's perfectly aligned now. Then, remember what I said about the hook point earlier? We'll look at that again here while I got you up close. You want that to go in like this so that it sits flat on the body of the bait and going straight, not like a dingus. Right? Okay, there it is. Let's go catch fish. We are straight up in this freaking dock. And I need to lift my motor up, first things first. Just lets all the fish know you're here and that you want to catch them when you do this. So we're good there. Now, boat out of the rocks. Push rod, heater series also doubles as a push pole. Keep your boat out of the rocks, dude. Do something quite controversial here. I think we're good. I need to use a trolling motor. I was gonna turn the big motor on, but I think I can reverse hoe out of here safely. I don't think the fish that was right here is gonna eat for me though. Maybe he will. I'll throw back up in there. Don't think I'm not gonna let it settle down and then throw back up in there, dog. I will. Another nice quad. Five quads in a row. All tanks. Another one on the line through. Turn any single swimmer into a line through swim bait. Top hook. Sick, dude. It's my first time ever fishing this bait. And I'm a believer. Tank quads left and right. Smash. We're crashing the boat left and right. We don't care, dog. I do care about my boat a lot, but a little bump on the Ultrex here and there, it never hurt anyone. JB's got it where it counts. She's like Wolverine. She recovers almost instantly. It's wild. Let's keep fishing. Threw right over there in the corner. Right there where I thought he'd be. And he'd be there. See if there's one over here in this corner. Uh-oh. Oh, we're going to get this one. Back to the dock cables. I just saw it go straight into a crevasse. It's in a crevasse, dude. These people that live up here probably listen to me talking to myself. Like, this dude's a blooming idiot. A blooming onion down there talking to himself in that bass boat. But anyways, I saw my bait just wedge itself into this crevasse. Oh, shoot. Keep it cool, Larry. We're cool, Larry. We're cool, Larry. You see what happens, Larry? You see what happens, Larry? All right. You see what happens, Larry, when you find a stranger in the Alps? Now I gotta go all the way around here and do all this again. Trolling motor on 37. Let's go. Go! What's up, Kyle? End of the season, huh, Kyle? One last hurrah. The wake surf boats just like look depressed now because it's starting to get cold. They just look bummed out. Party's over. We have to let these morons fish now. Yeah, our party's just now getting started, dude. We're happy about it. But yeah, the boat just looks sad and mad. But maybe they're, I don't know, maybe they're stoked because the water's still warm. I don't know. How cold is the water? 73 degree water. It just doesn't get that cold here on this lake. The water. Come on, fish. Bunch of bait, bunch of bait, bunch of bait. Bait everywhere, dudes. You can see them all in the water right here. Zoom in with the camera. See if you can show them the bait right here. They're everywhere. Giant quad, fish number six in the mix. It's a tank. Swung twice on this one. She just kissed it the first time. Nice. Knew she was over there though. Nice. Danger, high voltage, stay clear 200 feet, water intake structure. This facility operated in partnership with Inframark. Danger, danger, high voltage, stay clear 200 feet, water intake structure, danger, high voltage. That's about 200 feet, give or take. The 200 foot cast right there to fish your structure. Quads are cool and fun, but freaking where are the largemouth, dude? Got six in the mix, all quads, crazy. It's cool when you get a good skip and it's like, you know what I mean? That little purr across the top of the water. Skitty, skibbity, 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 bebop, skibbob, skibbity-doo. You know what I mean? Whatever. Whatever it is. Don't hate on it. Don't be a hater, dude. Just had a freaking niblet and he took my giblet. Freaking niblet took my giblet. Backed the boat up. All right, I don't know how well you guys could see that jumbled mess when I was doing it earlier, so I'm going to try and show you again here. You see, I'm going to go in a little low on the chin there. It's a little low. And then, once you get the bait all the way married up against the lead portion, you're gonna see how I didn't do it straight. You can kind of see how once you get it married up, the chin tucks right up under even with the bottom of the swim bait when you go just a little low. That's what you want. And you want that hook sitting flat. Only one right way to rig it, just like that. Boom. And now we're about this close to making contact with this gentleman's boat. I'm glad we didn't do that. Let's get back over here into my spot, see if this fish will eat for us again. Stole my giblet. I got a niblet and he stole my giblet. So that could be a nice one. Horsing on me a little bit. Just the fly. Oh, it is a nice one. Yeah, that's a good one. It's a large one. That'll help me get over it a little bit. All right, so you guys saw that. I just lost a big one. That's two videos in a row we lost a big one. It's just the way it goes sometimes. It wasn't my time. It wasn't a giant, it was a big one. Lost a bigger fish last video. This little quad right here, make up for it a little bit. Might've been a little bit of competition going on over there in that corner, which might be what got that big one to eat. She came off right at the boat. It sucks to lose that fish no matter what. It sucks to lose that fish. I know you guys could feel it on the boat there for a second. Feels good to catch another one, you know, same spot right after, but would have loved for fish number 7 to have been that big largemouth and not that quad, but away she goes, boys, away she goes. She was horsing on me a little bit, man, that's when I knew. And the bait disappeared. It wasn't like a thump. Like all these quads have been thumping it, you know? They're just running up and crashing it, really aggressive, hard, thumping bite. You feel the rod, you know, bounce in your hands when they collide with the bait. It wasn't like that on that one. It was more of a, you know, she ate that bait and all the water around it. They're out here though, and they're eating 7 fish so far. Can we break the 10 fish mark? It's been a long time since I caught 10 fish in one video. Let's do this. Only had a dragon on the way to the boat. Biffed it. That's what I get for trying to flip her. I was about to flip it. I was about to say, shout out to Captain Ron, boat flips only. She was coming up on that swing. She was coming up into the boat. One swing too many. 1 second too long in the water. I should have just flung her when I saw her coming up that first time. That's what I should have done. That's what I'm going to start doing, just flinging them into the boat. Forget trying to get them on the edge and get them up here on the carpet for this camera. I'm just gonna start flinging them into the floorboard. I'm tired of losing fish. I try to get the good camera shots for y'all so you guys can see me, you know, flipping them up onto the carpet here and or flipping them up into my hand at least. I try not to let fish touch the carpet if I can help it. Man, I might have to just start flipping these jokers into the floorboard until we get a couple of decents into the boat because I'm tired of having big fish come off on me. That ain't right. I was like, that don't feel right, but it thumped. What is that out there in the middle of nowhere? And one time I missed a giant right here. I remember that. On the swim jig. Got it on camera too. It's here on the channel. I can't remember what video it is, but I missed a giant here before. I know there are fish here. It's another quad. Fish number 8. Another freaking beautiful Guadalupe bass, man. They're tanks. I've never caught this many big quads in one video ever. It's freaking sick, dude. 7.2 medium heavy mod fast heater series rod. That freaking 3.5 inch whale ghost ice minnow on the 6 inch treble head line through. That right there, dude. That's where it's at. That's a match made in heaven. So sick. Beautiful long quad. 8 is great. Yeah. Mernon is the Vaughn. Another thick, healthy Guadalupe bass, man. Can't catch a largie to save our life, but I'll swing on these hand grenades all day long. You know me, I'm the freaking leader of the Guad Squad, boy. This is the best day of Guadalupe bass fishing that I've ever had. I should be weighing my best 5 guads. This is definitely the heaviest bag of guads that I've ever put together. Is this 9 fish? This one's stuck. 6-inch needle nose. Another healthy Guadalupe bass. 9 fish in the boat, would have been 10. And it would have been a dragon. Let's keep working, keep hunting. See if we can find her. See if we can find her eating, boys. Y'all having fun? I'm having fun. Good old fashioned JR fun fishing video with the 6-inch treble head line through. Let's keep going. Hit them with that. Bunch of grass right here. Treble head line through, coming through the grass like it's nothing. I like that. Feels just like a chatterbait. Thumping and then comes through the grass. Not a thing on the hooks. That's sick. Grass is super thick right here. There he is. Number 10 right here. Oh, he came off. Thumped it right on the back side of the grass. Not a blade of grass on the bay. I was about to say, here's number 10 if we can get him to the boat. He got lucky. He thumped it right before it got to the grass. Comes through the grass really well. It's interesting. There he is. Nice. Crushed it. Think it might be a large now. It is. Coming up here on the first swing. Yes. Is that number 10? Fish number 10 for the win. And it's the kind we were after. Finally got a largie in the boat. It's not as big as the one we lost, but I'll definitely take that one. It's a healthy fish. Not quite the dragon we missed earlier, but hey, beautiful. Nice, dude. What do y'all say we get us a nice release shot? This beautiful bass here in this beautiful clear water with all this beautiful hydrilla. Man, awesome. All right, off you go. Sick. All right, that's pretty awesome. Missed a couple here in these grass patches. I'm gonna push back out. I'm gonna cover it really well, and we're gonna keep grinding. But that was an excellent way to accomplish the mission and achieve that 10 fish mark. You see what I'm saying? Bass fishing is changing, and it's crucial nowadays. You have to adapt, guys. You know, the same old stuff, the stuff that I used to throw, the stuff that we used to do is just not working the way it used to work, guys. The swim jig, the crankbait, the big swim bait, the multi-joint, it's just not producing like it used to. And bass fishing is changing. There are more anglers. I don't think it has much to do with forward-facing sonar. I think it has to do with the fact that fish have seen more baits these days than they ever have, especially since the pandemic. There are more anglers out here on the water fishing than ever, and you just have to adapt. It's not only about downsizing, but it's also about showing the fish something different that they've never seen before, that mimics something that they're familiar with. That's the game that we play, right? That's the delicate balance that we're sort of caught in, the dance that we do with these fish. We try to find something new, innovative, show them an action and a type of bait that they've never seen before that also imitates something that they're super familiar with. It's such a juxtaposition, a yin and yang, the balance of bass fishing. Personally, I love it. It's one of the many reasons why I absolutely love being out here on the water, trying to figure these fish out and adapting with this little line through treble head swim bait has allowed me to do that today. You guys are witnessing it firsthand. It's the most productive day I've had out here on the water in a long time, and I don't plan on stopping here. We'll see if we can catch some more fish. If not, it's a win already. 10 for the win. I'm stoked on today. subscribe to the channel. The science of bass fishing. A little giblet. A little finesse swimmer, man. Awesome. Shout outs to the homie in the neighborhood, if you're watching, for rolling through with the intel. Give credit where credit is due. He told me that they were out here smashing it. So I came out here to try it myself, and that's what's going down. And I'm fishing it through the grass, and it's working. Through thick grass, this thing is just swimming through it. It's awesome. A little bit of grass on the hook that time, but it's healthy. Look at that healthy hydrilla, dude. Yeah. Nighttime temps are getting back down into the 50s. This grass is greening back up. Find the grass, find the bass. Oh, look at them. Look at them all. Look at them all. Look at them all. There was six or seven bass. Little wolf pack, dude. A wolf pack. That was crazy. I just got bit by multiple fish. Little guy. Ate it right here by the boat, though. Aw, man, he just freaking spit my whale off into the lake, man. So much for not going through soft plastics. These little guads, man, they destroying them. Not really. I think I've gone through like two, but there's another one. It's about time to retie. 11 fish without retying. That's retie time. Better safe than sorry.
Oh, we got a gentleman over here fishing.
Get out of his way. Did not even see that cat. And here's the deal. So here's a perfect example. You see this guy over here? He fishing coming this way. I didn't even see him, but I'm about to get out of his way because I'm not even that type of dude. So I'm just gonna let him have it. I'm gonna go this way.
How you doing today?
What's going on, boss? How are y'all?
Good.
Y'all catching him?
A few.
Right on. Yeah, it's been a pretty good day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thought y'all were crappie fishing for a second. I was about to tell y'all where a school was, but y'all fishing for bass, huh? Yeah, I didn't see y'all there, man. I meant to get out of y'all's way. Y'all have a good one. Yeah, if I don't catch another one in the next 20 minutes, I'm out. They're slowing down, I think. But it was good this morning, for sure. It's good chatting with y'all. Y'all have a good one. Before I call it a day, as the bite has really slowed down, I'm gonna throw the big whale parallel to this bluff wall. See if we can draw out a bigger bite. If I don't, that's gonna be it for me today. I'll throw this thing on the trailer. Whoa! Look at that freaking eagle just went down and smashed a fish out of the water. Now he's flying off with it. Bald eagle, America. Freaking America, dude. Yes, look, he's gonna do it again. Oh, he almost did it again. He's got one. Has he got one? Either way, that bald eagle just smashed into the lake. Looked like he was carrying a fish. That was awesome. Freedom. Let freedom ring. Very fitting for this time in our country, I'd say. Let freedom ring. I don't get political around here, but you know. Yeah, if you know, you know. And everybody knows, oh, look, it's a hawk. It's not a bald eagle. It's like a peregrine hawk or something. But it's sick. Look, that means the fish must be here. Hit it again. He's looking. He's hunting. That's sick, dude. Love the hawks and the eagles. It's so cool. Got a good one on. Try to throw the whale to draw out a bigger bite. That's number 12 on the day right there, man. Dirty dozen, picked up a bigger bait, drew out a bigger bite. Awesome, excellent way to end the video. Wanna give a massive shout out to Sixth Sense Fishing for helping me do what I do. You guys check out the Troublehead line through sixthsensefishing.com. Punch in that JR10 for the win. Secure the heater, save the bread, support the movement at the same time. Smash a dragon. Good times right there, man. Excellent way to end the video with a dirty dozen. Most fish I've caught in a single day in a single video out here on my home lake in a long time. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you did. If you're interested in supporting the channel even more, you can become a channel member and get access to some special perks. Man, you guys check that out. Top link down below in the video description. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Help us grow this thing to 100,000. I appreciate all of you for taking time out of your day to watch this video, but that's about all I got for you today. That about does it. That about wraps it on up. So I'm going to say goodbye for now. And I will see you on the next one. Hopefully catching more dragons out here with the heater series. The 6-inch heaters and the greenfish. Good times, man. Let's let this one go. Wrap it up. No better way to end the day than with a nice release shot of a healthy dragon. Awesome. Bye.